Ang reply niya, mataray. Tapos, funny laughing emoji. What's up, everyone, and welcome back to my vlog. Hi, it's Joyce again. Weird ng hi ko. Actually, itong ganito, nahuha ko to kay Wansh. Like, sobrang laki ng kamay niya. Tapos, pag nag-hi siya, lagi lang siyang... That pala ganyan. Hi! This is going to be a pretty fun video because hindi ko alam kung pretty fun for me or fun lang for you dahil pag-uusapan natin yung mga your assumptions about me. Okie dokie! So, let's start with my friends. Ito na, yung mga friends ko muna kasi nauna sila dun sa answer button eh. Sabi ni Inka Magnaye, I assumed you were super nice and I was right. Ano ba yun? Okay, o di sige. Thanks, Inks. Yeah, I'd like to think I'm nice. I'm generally a kind person naman, praise God. And I'm a very joyful person, as my name goes. Boom Jama, one of my producers from Unang Hirit, also one of my good friends. Ang reply niya, mataray. Tapos, funny laughing emoji. I kind of can be mataray. But here's the thing, I'm not as mataray as people think. And I always would get messages on Twitter na parang, dapat lalapitan kita sa mall kaso nakasimangot ka, or mukha kang masungit, or mukha kang mataray. But that's not my fault. It's a resting, ano, face. Okay, I'll show you ah. This is me when I'm smiling. Like, I look so happy, right? But when I'm not smiling, right? I don't know what it is. I guess it's the resting ano face. Ano? Ano? Parang ganun yung mukha ko. Ano? Ganun, di ba? Pag hindi ko nakasmile, ano? Ano gusto mo? Ano sasabi mo? Pero hindi naman talaga ganun. Pero, very different. I don't, whatever. Lo Young says, mataas ang tingin sa sarili and too cool for me. Thank God I was wrong. Love slash miss you. Thanks, Lo. Okay, yeah, I get it. I get it sometimes. I think it's my ano face and probably sometimes the way that I speak. Next, very outgoing. Yes, I'm very adventurous, very outgoing. I would go off and do different adventures all the time. Climb a mountain, go scuba diving, travel on my own. Except eat exotic food. Yan ang hindi ko pa ever nagagawa. As in, parang hindi ko kayang kumain ng uod. Dahil lagi mo sinasabi sa sarili ko, bakit ko gagawin yun? At saka, natatakot ako kasi pag yung uod na yun, buhay pa pala, tapos nagstay siya sa loob ng tiyan mo, tapos kakainin niya yung tiyan mo, nakakatakot yun. Hindi ko alam kung posible yung mangyari, but I don't know. Another one. Spoiled kay Kuya Wancho. I love you both. Sabi ni Ruiz Kath. Am I spoiled? Yeah, a little bit. I think a little bit maybe. Wancho kasi is very maalaga. So, there are some things that I've stopped doing when we started to date and when we became a couple. Like, I stopped driving because for some reason, he's a very old school type of guy and he doesn't let the girl drive. So, he has made it a point that he gave me his driver, the driver that I, when I met him, yun yung driver niya, si Kuya Jarwin. So, binigyan niya na sa akin yung driver ko. Tapos, every time coding ako, siya yung walang sasakyan. Tapos, ipapahiram niya sa akin yung sasakyan niya para gamitin ko with his driver. And then, for example, pag hindi talaga kaya na wala yung driver or nasa kanya dahil may taping siya, ang ginagawa niya, ibubook niya ako ng Grab as in siya mismo yung magbubook para siya yung magbabayad to pick me up from wherever I am to bring me where he is para mahatid niya ako or something. So, medyo spoiled ako that way. But, not naman spoiled rotten. As in, balanced naman kami. We make it a point that we really take care of each other. Next! Jenjenenen29 says, intimidating! I don't know if I'm intimidating. A lot of people, especially my guy friends, would tell me that I do have the tendency to be intimidating. But let it be known that I am not doing that on purpose. I am not trying to be intimidating. But I do understand where it's coming from. It's probably, again, because of my big personality. It can be a big personality. So I guess that's where the intimidating part comes in. I also started working when I was very young. So ang dami kong friends who are older than me, which I think make me think a lot older than I actually am. I'm only 26 and most of my friends are just relaxed, partying, and you know, relax lang talaga. But me, medyo intense kasi ako, especially when it comes to work and to professionalism and getting your goals straight and doing things so that it'll bring you closer to your future goal. Medyo intense ako that way. Here's a great assumption from Captain Vivi. If you don't need to, you don't wear makeup. That is correct, sir. I don't wear makeup on my regular days. I kind of am wearing a little bit of makeup right now because I came from a surprise date with Wancho. But usually, I don't wear makeup. I do like wearing makeup because it's fun to be a girl and it's fun to dress up. But I don't like the feeling of having so much on my face. I feel like I can't be myself too. Alam mo yun, parang you have to be proper kasi when you're wearing makeup kasi hindi ka pwede masyadong parang kailangan medyo subdued ng konti. So, yeah. Jay Vielpre says, Kuripot! That is actually a wrong assumption. I can say that completely. Hindi ako kuripot. I'm very galante. Minsan too generous. Too galante, actually. The common financial mistake that I make is I'm hiya when I ask for my friends to come with me to dinner. I feel like I'm obliged to buy them dinner because you know you're asking for their time. And usually, because my friends are the ones to adjust to my schedule because I'm the busier one most of the time. So, parang hindi naman ako na obliged, pero parang feeling ko kailangan ako yung magmanlibre, mang ganyan. Ganun akong type of person ko. So, wrong! I am not kuripot! Yay! Engineer Maan says, you're boyish yet a girl sometimes. That is a great assumption and I'm glad that you saw that in me. You know, my outfit today is actually the perfect visual representation of I am boyish but also girly at times. So, I'm wearing this dress. Ta-da! I'm wearing a pink dress, see? Hindi to pantulog, promise. I'm wearing a pink dress, but I'm wearing like this huge jacket of mine. And I'm also wearing my sneakers. So, yeah, I like to think I'm a little bit of boyish and girly. Hindi ko kaya maging super pa girl or hindi ko rin kaya maging super pa boy. So, a little bit of both. Okay, next. Hindi nag-uulit ng damit. Mali yan, Angel. Lagi ako nag-uulit ng damit. Pero lagi ko siyang inuulit in such a way na hindi niyo mapapansin. So, I'm glad that that's your assumption. Because it's wrong! Dahil mahal bumili ng damit kung bili ka ng bili. So, kailangan maging smart ka at bumili ka ng mga pieces na pwede mong i-recycle every so often. Tin Garcia 30 says, mayaman. Ha ha ha! Hindi mayaman, sakto lang. Feeling ko I work smart enough, I work hard enough that I live now a comfortable life. But I haven't always lived a comfortable life. I haven't always had money. There were times na as in wala talaga akong pera to the point na I had to ask my friends to bring me home or uutang ako ng 200 pesos para lang may pang-uwi ako galing sa audition or galing sa trabaho or galing sa school. Most of my life, except the past maybe 5 years, it was spent really just going from one day to another, surviving. As in, okay lang, surviving lang, surviving. Whatever God has given me all these years, I try my best to give it to others, to share it with others, so that I can bring glory to His name. Because I'm nothing without the Lord. I'm nothing without the talents that He has given me or the opportunities that He has given me to share and to show those said talents so that I'll be paid to do this. So, yeah, hindi talaga ako mayaman galing sa mahirap. But it's not the sob story. It's actually a great story. I'm not mayaman. Ngayon, parang malapit na. Malapit na, hindi malayo pa. Pero pag may mga gusto mag-business dyan, baka gusto nyo naman ako i-business partner para dumami din yung pera ko. Anywho, okay. Alicia Salenga says, hindi mahirap pakisamahan. Thank you, Alicia, for that very kind assumption. Yeah, I'd like to say that madali akong pakisamahan dahil laging sinasabi sa akin na madali akong pakisamahan at na magaling akong makisama. But I think it's because of my God-given talent to become a pleasing person. As in, ako lang yung type of person na gusto kong mag-please ng other people. I don't want to do anything that's not gonna be healthy for everyone. I don't want to do anything that's gonna be offensive to other people. I try to love them and be gracious to them as much as I can. So, that's why. Okay, next. Migs Tranco says, makulit kasama pag tropa, masungit pag hindi kilala. Kind of true, but I wouldn't say masungit. I'm quiet. When I warm up to people, I warm up pretty fast, but I do have to warm up first. Parang boxing. Okay, next. It's me, Kim Sanity says, T tita na madaming nakakatawang kwento pag may mga family gathering. Oo, ako yun. Ako yung tita na madaming kwento, madami akong jokes pag may family gathering. At saka, siguro kasi yung trabaho ko, I go to different places and I meet all sorts of people all the time. So I have so much kwento to my friends and to my family whenever I see them. So yes, madami akong kwento. Pero hindi naman ako tita. Hello, 26 pa lang ako. Medyo, technically tita naman talaga ako, dalawang mga pamangkin na ako. The Rashawn XOXO says, "You're a nerd. I used to be a nerd. I used to be a book nerd. I used to love sciences and the maths, and I was best in biology, and I read like 8 books in 1 month. Joke lang, OA yung 8 books. Yung mga 4 books in 1 month. Yeah, I used to be a nerd, not anymore. I'm still knowledgeable, but I'm not a nerd." Carlo Leon says, "High maintenance. Wow! I'm pretty low maintenance. And you can ask Juancho or any of my friends about this. I am one of the most low maintenance people that you will ever meet. As in, sobrang I can survive off of so little. Basta bigyan mo lang ako ng tubig at pagkain. At jacket, kasi malamigin ako. Okay na ako. Hindi mo ako kailangan asikasuhin. So, very low maintenance. You know, weird ka, Carlo Lien, kasi never pa akong na-brand as high maintenance. But, maybe. Wow, bumabranding na ako ng high maintenance. Fairness. Okay. Kian Kunanan, kala ko bad girl ka. Ano ba ang definition of a bad girl? Kung ang definition natin ng bad girl ay kung sino ako before, which is yosi, inom, party, banda, ganyan. Siguro, oo. Pero I don't think that's necessarily a bad girl. And it was a phase, you know. It was a phase where I would go out almost every night and I'd get drunk and, you know, it's just, it wasn't good for my health. And if you're currently doing that, I'm not gonna judge you. I'm not gonna tell you that you're a bad girl or you're a bad person. But what you're doing can be bad for your health and it's not helping you to become a better person. So whatever is not bringing you to better is probably bringing you to worse. Yeah, I was a bad girl once. Rakista pa rin, pero Christian na ako ngayon. So, iba na yung standards ko of living because I want to glorify God. So, no longer a bad girl. Trying to be a good girl. Next. You seem to be one tough yet vulnerable woman. Yes, I am one of those softies on the inside and pa strong on the outside. I would like to think I'm a very strong-hearted, strong-willed person. God has given me that strength and I'm not afraid. I'm very courageous because I just know myself. I know myself and I know who my God is. So because of that, I have courage. But also, I'm very vulnerable in the sense that I get hurt easily. When somebody tells me that I'm not good enough, I actually take it to heart. Oh, nga, I'm not good enough. Ganun akong type of person. As in, it sinks into me whenever people hurt me. That's why I never wanted to be artista or I never wanted to be in showbiz na mainstream talaga. Kasi natatakot ako na pag mas madami taong nakakilala sa'yo, napapansin ko kasi na mas marami talagang mga hateful comments, mga talagang... Hi, grabe. People can be so mean on the internet. And that's why I never went that route of being a celebrity or being an artista. I never went that route blatantly. Maybe it has become, you guys watching this, it has become a byproduct of what I love to do, which is I love to speak, I love to be in front of the camera, I love to make people happy. And it has become a byproduct that I have a lot of people following me and watching me. But I never wanted to be popular or famous because I knew that I was sensitive. Next! Joey Miguel _ says, "It'll be hard arguing with you because you're too smart. That is an assumption I'm not gonna comment on, but you may go to Juancho Trevino on Instagram and on YouTube and ask him yourself if that statement is true." Okay, last one from Bulensky. "Independent and very strong personality. Those are two things that describe me perfectly. Independent and very strong personality." And I know that because I'm a very independent, I'm a very strong personality, that I get a lot of misconceptions, wrong assumptions about me. And that's okay. I think it's great that people know me to a certain level, but people also don't know me to some extent. And I'm really grateful that through platforms like these, I can tell you that, yeah, I'm not mataray, I'm not alta, I'm not masungit, I'm not kuripot. I'm medyo pabebe, I'm medyo spoiled kay Juancho, But I like to think that God is really changing my heart to become more like Him and to be kind and to be more loving and to be more humble, even though I'm independent and strong personality. So there! Those are excited. That's it for this episode of my vlog. Maraming salamat po. So don't forget to like this video, share it with the people that you love, and don't forget to subscribe and click the notification button to get notified when I have new videos on this channel. Okay, I'll see you guys soon. Bye!